Welcome to Burhill Golf Club. My name is Jill Fee and I'm the Sales and Marketing Manager for Burhill Golf Club. We're in Walton-on-Thames in Surrey. We have a magnificent Georgian mansion house here in between two 18-hole golf courses. The River Mole runs through the middle and we have magnificent views out the back. It's an absolute ideal venue for an exclusive use at wedding. We are just off the A3 at junction 10 on the M25, only 20 minutes from Heathrow and probably 25 minutes from Gatwick, and probably about 25 miles out of central London, so extremely easy to get to. There's a lot of very nice hotels in the area. We can accommodate here up to 104 for a wedding breakfast and 150 for an evening reception. The mansion house would be yours for the duration of your wedding, normally from about 3 o'clock in the afternoon through to 1 o'clock in the morning. Booking that is very easy. We just contact my office and tell me your dates, and if we can accommodate, we'd be absolutely delighted to have you. We can accommodate up to 104 for a wedding breakfast and 150 for an evening reception. Unfortunately, we aren't licensed, so we can't hold ceremonies here, but we do have the Ivor Lounge and we have the Barnes Wallis Suite for your wedding breakfast. This is the Barnes Wallis Suite. We can accommodate up to 104 here for a seated wedding breakfast. We have the beautiful views across the golf courses, over the River Mole. It's air conditioned and is a blank canvas with white linen and just very neutral colours. There are very few venues that you can have exclusive use, so we are very popular because of that criteria. The person that would marry here would like a traditional venue with exquisite food, very good customer service, and they would be assured of a dedicated person to look after them for their day. It always helps if one of them is interested in golf, because obviously we're more than happy to extend a round of golf after the stag night to clear his head. We have an award-winning chef, Andy Owen, who's recently been voted Golf Club Chef of the Year, which we're extremely proud of. We have an extensive wine list and a group of staff that are very versed in dealing with weddings. We have our own dedicated person in the sales office who can help plan the day, but we have no problems at all if they feel more at ease with having a wedding planner to organise the day for them. We would encourage any summer brides to actually have their wedding reception arrival drinks out on the putting green here in front of the mansion house. It's just lovely when the bride arrives right outside in front of their guests. We would then take them through into the reception area for meet and greet. We have the Ivor Lounge, and then upstairs for the wedding breakfast into our Barnes Wallis Suite, which overlooks the 18th hole of our new course and the River Mole. It's extremely important to us that our brides have the best day of their lives, and we're very lucky that we get some beautiful letters and feedback saying how good the staff are and how welcoming the staff are, and I think that's of paramount importance to us, that we know that we're delivering and that all the brides are happy.
Hi, I'm Craig Davis, General Manager of Addington Palace. The history of the building really is as rich as it is varied. The main building actually predates the Domesday Book, or the actual site itself. Reputedly, there was even a hunting lodge here where Henry VIII used to have clandestine meetings with Anne Boleyn. In more recent times, the main house was built in 1776, actually built for a chap called Barlow Tregothick, and he commissioned an architect called Robert Milne to build the house as you see it today. After that, 1805 to 1896, it was the Archbishop's Palace. Six archbishops resided here, five of whom are buried in St Mary's Church in the village. It was a Red Cross building in the First World War, and for 44 years it was home to the Royal School of Church Music. More recently, we've been running as a conference and wedding venue. We do about 100 or so weddings a year. Upon the initial inquiry, when the clients rang up, they'd see our sales manager. And she'd show them around the venue, she'd show them around the palace and the marquee, get a full tour of the building, be told about the history of the palace as well. If they then decide to book, they would then have their own dedicated event manager. Now, the beauty of this is it ensures continuity right from the very start. It also allows them to build up a rapport with the event manager. The event manager would see them right through until the day itself, so effectively from conception to birth of the actual function. Something that the Palace does offer, which very, very few venues can, is a range of numbers. Now, we can do weddings for 40 to 120 in the Palace, from 150 to 750 in the Marquee. Now, the Marquee is a semi-permanent debauch structure. The problem with when you say Marquee to people, they think of some flappy side, sort of coconut matting, summer structure that's been put up. This certainly isn't that. This is a permanent fixture, and it's fully self-contained. Has its own bar down there, its own dedicated kitchen, fully heated and fully air-conditioned, so throughout the year it can be used. Numbers-wise, it's incredibly versatile. You can go up to 750 for a reception. As far as the actual venue is concerned, because it's not bespoke, you can change it, you can set it up exactly as you wish. You're really hiring a blank canvas. The focal point, of course, is the Great Hall. It really is a stunning room, and every bride-to-be can't help but fall in love with it. So here we are in the magnificent Great Hall, which really is the heartbeat of the house. We can accommodate 60 to 120 in here for a sit-down wedding breakfast. And it is a tremendous room with so many features, a couple of which, this beautiful Italian marble fireplace, fantastic chandelier, and the walnut wall panelling, just to mention a few. We have an incredibly talented team of chefs here. All our catering is in-house. However, we do allow you to bring in your own outside caterers in the Marquee. What I will say about our chef is he's incredibly talented and he can offer diverse cuisine, European, African Caribbean, and even Mexican, which is one of his specialities. He's part of my team that was here for the Queen's Golden Jubilee in July 2002, and I really do think that speaks for itself. Other areas in the Palace include the lecture room and library, which are fantastic lounges, and they work really well for the older generation, a room to retire to if they don't want to be in the hubbub of the disco, which of course is in the Great Hall later on in the evening. We also have the dining room, which is a popular room for the evening buffet, which looks out upon the south lawn. I think we're a very affordable venue, and I think we can tailor make packages financially to suit your needs. I think we're also extremely flexible. And by that, I mean that you can actually change the package, you can incorporate certain elements, whatever the bride and groom want, each package is tailored accordingly. And finally, and probably most importantly, is we're a very personable venue. Our staff are incredibly fastidious. They work very hard with each client, and every client is different. And we're very proud of our reputation, and I think that really does make us the ultimate wedding venue.
My name is Jane Jones. I'm the events manager here at Hurtwood Park Polo Club. We are set in the glorious Surrey countryside at the foot of the Surrey Hills. We are a fully fledged polo club. We've got 6 polo grounds. The clubhouse was built probably about 12 years ago, and it started out as just a fully licensed bar and restaurant. People started coming to us and said, oh, I like this, can I have my wedding? And then just over the past sort of 7 or 8 years, the need for weddings has just increased. And this is our fabulous clubhouse, it's a 16th century barn, which was relocated from a village not far from here. And we built it, designed it, and we hold quite a few weddings. This is a wedding that's set up for about 70 people. We can take quite comfortably about 90 people in here. Obviously the barn has great character and great atmosphere. It's really, really comfortable. People enjoy having, we have a very, very relaxed service. We set up, we break down, we have entertainment, usually located at the far end of the barn. And all in all, a perfect venue for your wedding. First, obviously, port of call. Our website's got some, you know, most of the information about weddings. Then they would call the office. We'd arrange a meeting or an appointment to meet up with usually the bride and groom, occasionally the in-laws. And we meet up and we talk through every step of what they require for their day. Some of them are quite small, some of them are a bit bigger. We go through the food, florist, entertainment, everything that they need. Our catering is run by our chef, who's James McLaren Clark, and we've got quite a full and varied menu for people to choose from. We also work off menu, so if people have something a little bit different, they want sausage and mash or shepherd's pie, we're quite prepared to do that.
Hello, my name's James McLaren Clark. I'm the head chef here at Hurtwood Park Polo Club. Been here for three and a half years now. We've been developing our wedding packages quite extensively over the last few years, trying to integrate more into a modern sort of European style way of cooking, using lots of fresh local produce, try and keep it as organic as possible. We always use free range, fully sustainable food. All our beef has a full sustainability.
We've got a fully inclusive package. We charge for the meal. That includes everything you need, the plates, the cutlery, the crockery, linen. And then we have a venue hire fee, which varies between summer and winter. With all of our packages, we recommend people. We also suggest, you know, people have relatives that are florists. We've got our list of preferred suppliers that we like people to use, but they're not beholden to it. They can use who they want. Entertainment packages range from a disco up to a sort of nine-piece band. We do all sorts of weddings. We do them from young to old. We've had a few second marriages, and they tend to be a little bit older in age. We do small weddings. I think our smallest has probably been about 40, up to 300. We offer quite a bespoke service. We like to find out what people want and really work with their needs and their wants, as opposed to sort of imposing too much of ourselves on them. We're always there for advice. We always have different people and different things that we can offer. We like people's input. We like to feel their input and really live their wedding with them.